But the echoes of the Jubilee celebrations had scarcely faded before it became known that the king was again gravely ill. During his previous long illness in 1928, the companionship of his baby granddaughter did much to hasten his recovery. But this time it was not to be. On January the 20th, 1936, a BBC announcement prepared the nation for news that was inevitable.
This is London. Following bulletin was issued at 9:25. The king's life is moving peacefully towards its close.
Shortly after midnight, the king died, and a quarter of a century of devoted service had ended. It was Princess Elizabeth's first experience of family loss. And 8 days later, she saw her beloved Grandpapa England laid to rest with his forebears at Windsor.
The members of foreign royal families in their uniforms, King Haakon of Norway, King Christian of Denmark, King Boris of Bulgaria, King Leopold of Belgium, King Carol of Romania, and then, alone, a state landau drawn by the Windsor Greys. Within is Her Majesty Queen Mary.
The death of a king and the proclamation of his successor, Edward VIII, civil war in Spain, the occupation of the Rhineland, mobilization of Mussolini's armies for the invasion of defenseless Abyssinia, 1935 and 1936. These were momentous years, culminating in an event which was to have a profound effect on the future of the 10-year-old Princess Elizabeth.
This is London. A quarter of an hour ago, the Prime Minister came to the bar of the House and handed to the Speaker a message from His Majesty the King. Here is the text of the message, which was read by the Speaker. After long and anxious consideration, I have determined to renounce the throne, to which I succeeded on the death of my father. And I am now communicating this, my final and irrevocable decision.
The instrument of abdication, executed on the morning of the 10th of December, 1936, brought the young princess into the direct line of succession. 5 months later, on May the 12th, 1937, she drove through cheering crowds in the royal procession to Westminster Abbey and saw the coronation of her parents, King George VI and Queen Elizabeth. Amidst the ceremonial pomp and pageantry of this great occasion, there were the simple but never to be forgotten moments.
The king slowly, with measured tread, moves forward, walking firmly, passing towards the theatre, and in the royal gallery, Queen Mary turns towards him and watches him, and I think I see her smile. And only a few feet from their father, the little princesses look on intently. He's passing them now.
And then the great drive in state through cheering crowds lining the route from Westminster Abbey to Buckingham Palace.